All right. Well, hello and welcome. Welcome and hello. Today is Thursday, which means that it is vlog day, and that's what we do on Thursdays, as we always do. We sit and we vlog, and I have a whole mess of stuff to talk about today. Let me get my vlog notes out. Before we do anything, I always ramble a little bit, but I do want to get my vlog notes out. We do have a lot of stuff to talk about. There's an update to that titanium wire situation that I was talking about last week. There is some advocacy stuff. We will have shout-outs, beer, hopefully some viewer mail, definitely some first impressions, and definitely a retro vaping segment. Sounds good. So let's move forward. So the first thing that I wanted to talk about is, well, this is going to have to wait till next week. There's a Beyond Vape customer survey. I can't get into that right now. It's going to take up too much time. I'm going to have to wait to do that next week. So next week we will do the Beyond Vape customer survey. The first thing on the docket that I wanted to talk about is California SB 140. This bill, let me turn down my Facebook notifications. This bill is ridiculous. This bill is obscene. I posted a picture on my Instagram. It was a repost, SB 140. You can all go like it, follow me on Instagram. SB 140, no cloud comps. That's basically what SB 140 means. Vote no on SB 140, no vaping indoors, no vaping in shops. Fight for your right, call your California assemblyman and demand no on SB 140, which would extensively kill vaping indoors in vape shops. If you own a vape shop, I'm going to a cloud comp this Saturday at local vape. No, that wouldn't exist. There would be no such thing. There would be no gathering indoors of vaping in California. It just simply wouldn't exist. The way they put it on here is they say the truth about SB 140 is that we'll kill the vaping industry in California. The only thing traditional tobacco products and e-cigarettes have in common is nicotine. This would be like saying a roller skate is a Rolls Royce, a unicycle is a Harley Davidson, and a tugboat is an aircraft carrier. Very good analogies, actually. Call your local California assembly member and tell them to vote no on SB 140. So what I'm going to do in the description to this video is link you to the bill, SB 140. You can see the whole thing. This is the one that was introduced by Senator Mark Leno not too long ago, and it shows everybody who's involved with it, all the ins and outs of everything. I mean, this is a fuck ton. This is a lot to read. There's a lot going on here. Additionally, what I'm going to do, if you want to sit and read this whole bill, which I've been trying to get through most of it, but they use a lot of quotation marks like smoking and tobacco products. And to me, that just seems ridiculous. That's like saying, oh, I'm only going to watch 5 or 6 episodes of Ink Master. No, you're going to sit and watch the whole season. It's weird that they use air quotes as smoking and smoking permitted areas. I don't know why they do that. I don't know why they do that, and it bothers me. But if you want to go read this whole bill, you can. More importantly, what I'm going to do, if you're a California resident, I am going to link in the description to the list of California State Assembly members. And what I did and what I would encourage you to do is target Republicans first. And I'm not saying that as any sort of like dig at Democrats. I would target Republicans first and play the small business card, play the small private business card. It should be up to the businesses to decide if they should allow vaping inside their establishments. That's just plain and simple. That's something that should happen. It shouldn't be governed by the state. It shouldn't be this sort of nanny state that's going on. The first one I came across, Alan Travis. So I called the district office of Alan Travis, and I got a voice message machine. It said, our hours are Monday through Friday. It was noon on a weekday, so I don't know why nobody answered the phone. But I did leave a message. I left my phone number. I said, if you need any more information, feel free to call me back. Be very polite. Be very respectful. Additionally, what you can do on this website on that lists the California Assembly members is you can click. It says, contact Assembly Member Travis Allen. And when you do that, it takes you to a little page where you put in your name and address and phone number. And then it gives you like 2,000 characters to write a little blurb about what you want to contact Travis Allen about. So mine says, I haven't sent it yet. I'm going to submit it right as I'm done reading it. And I basically just did a copy paste of this into a Word document, and I'm going to go through all of the California Assembly members, starting with the Republicans, and copy and paste this exact thing in there, obviously changing the names. Hello, Mr. Allen. My name is Nick Green, and I'm a resident, business owner, and taxpayer in the state of California. I'm urging you to vote against California SB 140, which would categorize electronic cigarettes as tobacco products and would also make using electronic cigarettes indoors illegal. This includes the vape shops selling these vapor products. Vaping has helped tens of thousands of California residents move away from traditional tobacco products, and categorizing them as a tobacco product is ridiculous, as well as would be... So vaping has helped tens of thousands of California residents move away from traditional tobacco products, and categorizing them as a tobacco product would be ridiculous as well as detrimental to public health. As a former 15-year smoker that has finally gotten away from combustible tobacco products thanks to vaping, this bill would not only impact myself, but all the other California residents who have also been able to make the switch thanks to vaping and electronic cigarettes. I do believe that it should be up to the business to decide what activities can and cannot be allowed to happen in their place of business and not be reprimanded or dictated to by the state. Thank you so much for your time. There it is. That's what I'm writing to assembly person Travis Allen. Submit. Oh, what? What? Please correct the fields with asterisks. There are no fields with asterisks. Oh, I oppose. So what you have to do is, it says select an issue, and they have like these top issues on there. It's SB 128, end of life, SB 277, public health vaccinations, help with state agency, a meeting request, support gun control, oppose gun control, SB 2016 education comments. So what I did is I selected 2015 to 2016 comments on legislation, and then in your comments you specify the bill number. So I clicked oppose, I left my little note, I'm going to submit it. Go. Submit. Address is not in district. Please contact your district representative. Oh, Travis Allen, you're letting me down. Okay, well, I'm going to have to find now my district. I apologize, I still have a little bit of a sniffle going on. I'm going to have to find out who my district representative is. Because obviously it's not Travis Allen. So I apologize, Travis. You're not going to get to, you're not going to get this. Why can't I submit this? That pisses me off. Anyway, you have to contact your district representative. You're not able to contact all of the assembly members. Okay, well, he's in Huntington Beach, California. That makes sense. That's Sacramento, Santa Monica. I'm gonna find my district representative, and I'm gonna copy paste that exact thing, obviously with a different name on there. But yeah, this SB 140 is ridiculous. And rest assured that if SB 140 passes in California, things are not going to go well for the rest of the country. New York City and California are like these states where everybody else will model their legislation after. California tends to go over the deep end a little bit in a lot of respects to a lot of things. According to California, everything gives you cancer. California is a very, very weird, weird state as far as legislation and organic, and now we're in a drought, and all there's all this weird nonsense going on in California. But rest assured that if this passes in California, it will not be good for the rest of the country. And I do believe that. I do believe that. Next week, I'll have to touch on that next week. So real quick, I don't remember who sent me this, but there's a convention going on. MidCon VapeCon, which doesn't really roll off the tongue very well, but it's called MidCon VapeCon 2015. And I'm going to post a link in the description to MidCon VapeCon 2015. Why don't you put the dates and the location right on the front page? Dates and location. Event organizers. If you're throwing an event, just put the dates in the location right on the front page. That's all. I don't want to click more links to find out about you, find out about the event, have to watch a video to figure out the dates. That is ridiculous. So it's going to be October 23rd and 24th, 2015 in Joplin, Missouri. So all of you Missouri vapers, there is a big event that's coming to you. This is MidCon VapeCon. God, that's such a weird name. But anyway, MidCon VapeCon is happening, Missouri, Joplin, Missouri. And I'll post a link in the description to where you can check that out. Kevin sent me over, not Kevin from VP Live, different Kevin, just a random Kevin, sent me over this picture of the CDC has taken out a bunch of ads in magazines. He took a picture of it and sent it to me, and there's this sort of depressed looking girl in a red or in a pink sweater, and the big headline on it, big bold letters, it says, "I started using e-cigarettes, but I kept smoking until my right lung collapsed." That's what it says. Oh no, I said that wrong. "I started using e-cigarettes, but kept smoking right up until my lung collapsed." So basically this lady, if this is to be believed, she started using e-cigarettes and then kept smoking and then her lung collapsed. And they're blaming e-cigarettes, they're blaming vaping on her lung collapsing. That is ridiculous. That is the most ridiculous shit I have ever read in my entire life. It goes on, let me zoom in a little bit so I can read this a little bit better. "Christy had a smoker's cough and severe shortness of breath. She tried using e-cigarettes to cut down on her smoking. She thought cutting down would make her feel better, but it didn't. She kept smoking multiple cigarettes until the day her lung collapsed." And they're blaming e-cigarettes on this. They're basically saying e-cigarettes didn't help this person. They made her keep smoking and then her lung collapsed. So thanks a lot, e-cigarettes. That is ridiculous. That, God, that pisses me off. That makes no sense. That literally makes less than no sense. That's like saying I was an alcoholic and I started drinking water, but I kept drinking alcohol anyway, and then I got liver poisoning. Thanks for nothing, water. You didn't help. That is ridiculous. That is ridiculous. The CDC is out of their mind. Out of their mind. Out of their mind. That made me rage. That made me very upset. Let me know in the comments below what you think about that, because I think it's ridiculous. Additionally, Kaiser Permanente. Mike sent me over this link to Kaiser Permanente, and I thought I had the link. Yeah, I do have it up here. It comes from partnersinhealth.kaiserpermanente.org. "Three reasons to say no to e-cigarettes. Electronic cigarettes are marketed as a safer alternative to traditional cigarettes, but the way to manage nicotine cravings if you're trying and a way to manage nicotine cravings if you're trying to quit. But here are three good reasons to give them the thumbs down." Let's see. Thank you, Kaiser Permanente. Of course, you're a big, large, obscenely large pharmaceutical company. You would have no stake in people not smoking cigarettes. "Safety concerns. After analyzing e-cigarette samples, the U.S. Food and Drug Administration found that some products contain cancer-causing agents and toxic chemicals such as diethylene glycol, an ingredient used in antifreeze." They're still fucking using the antifreeze argument. The antifreeze argument. You know what else is an antifreeze? Water. Water is an antifreeze. Additionally, this is the study that was done in 2009 that turned out to be highly, 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 highly wrong. Wrong. You're basing this off of bad, false, wrong information, Kaiser Permanente. No convincing evidence that they will help you quit. No convincing evidence that they will help you quit. I could probably, with my ability as a YouTuber, probably get, I don't know, 10, 20, 30,000 people to come forward and say that, yes, vaping helped me quit smoking. There's no evidence they will help you quit. In fact, there is evidence suggesting the opposite. In 2014 study by researchers at the University of California, San Diego, shocking, California, they revealed that smokers who use e-cigarettes are a third less likely to quit than those who don't use them. A third less likely to quit, which means if you are a smoker and you start using vaping, you have less of a chance of quitting than just a smoker who wants to quit and just quits cold turkey. Are you kidding me, Kaiser Permanente? Are you out of your fucking mind? Third, what's proven to work still works. This is basically saying, ignore this brand new, amazing, life-changing product that is affecting hundreds of thousands of people and getting them away from traditional tobacco, cigarettes. We still make things that work. What we make still works. Evidence shows that the most effective way to quit is to use a combination of FDA-approved medications. Evidence shows that Kaiser Permanente are a bunch of fucking morons, like the nicotine patch, gum, lozenge, and bupropion. Huh, I wonder if Kaiser Permanente sells the nicotine patch, the gum, or the lozenge. And counseling support. Choose what works for you. Use Kaiser Permanente's wellness group coaching by phone. Tap into the power of a group in a health education stop smoking class. Try the online self-paced program called Health Media Breathe. Oh, fantastic, Kaiser Permanente. The best thing is they don't allow any comments on this. Of course they wouldn't allow comments on this. Why would they? Because they would get ripped apart, basically. So yeah, thank you, Kaiser Permanente, for showing that it's far more important to you to sell your nicotine patches than to actually give a shit about people quitting. This is ridiculous. I'm all fired up. I can't keep doing this. Let's move on to something else. And I'll post a link in the description if you want to give them more traffic, although I wouldn't do it. Kaiser Permanente, bunch of fucking morons over there. So what we're going to do now is we're going to update some titanium wire. Last week I talked about titanium wire. Stealthvape.co.uk released a statement saying that they couldn't in good conscience sell titanium wire because of chemical fires and stuff like this. Nope, that's the Kaiser Permanente link. I don't want that. I want this one. Give me this one. Give me Stealth Vape. So they recently updated this, and I don't want to read the whole thing, but evidently they basically backpedaled and said, don't pay attention to what we said before. There's a middle portion here that's kind of like a good part. It says, as you might be aware, we purchased 30,000 meters of top-grade TI wire, and 3 full kilometers of it is still lurking underneath a pile of jumpers and spare Christmas wrapping paper. Despite providing a cleaner vape to Canthal, we felt it prudent not to sell it due to its combustibility on the mods available at the time. With a number of temperature-controlled devices now out in the marketplace, we have seen the proclivity for titanium to burst into flames has been greatly reduced. Despite this positive result, we strongly caution against using titanium as a standard resistance wire. It is unsuitable for dry burning and possesses a risk when overheated. They're just covering their own ass. It is springier to work with than tempered nickel 200. But we are pleased to see that the development of temperature control boards appear to have facilitated a way to use this wire in a safe manner. Also, annealed titanium has entered into the market, which appears to be much easier to work with. Titanium wire also appears to be less prone to oxidation than alternatives due to the low oxygen content of the metal, which may well prove to be positive in the long run. I'll post a link in the description to where you can read this whole article. Additionally, a fellow contacted me on Facebook named Ari, and he has a whole video. Ari comes from Sweet Spot Vapors, and he does a bunch of wire titanium tests. It's a 16-minute long Vimeo video. He hooks it up to all sorts of meters and scopes. It never bursts into flames. There's no chemical fire. Basically, in the end, what needs to happen is I'm just going to buy some titanium wire. I'm going to buy some titanium wire. I'm going to build with it. I'm going to vape with it. I haven't purchased any titanium wire. If you know of a good spot, maybe to get some annealed titanium wire, let me know. Because I would like to get some, and I would like to build with it. Because, I mean, in the end, me using it, me building it, is going to be really how I will decide if I could recommend it to somebody or not. Not reading, Sweet Spot Vapors, going oh no, it's totally safe. And then stealthvape.co.uk going, oh well, it's kind of safe if you use it correctly. I don't know why I'm so hiccupy. We have some water here. So yeah, updates on titanium wire, sweet spot vapors, as well as stealthvape.co.uk. What we're gonna do now that we're 21 minutes into the video, let me just have a quick vape. I've been using this Calyx tank a lot. I got a black Evic VT. I put the Calyx on here. I got one of those just the tip drip tips. It reminds me of Aladdin. It's been fantastic. This has kind of been my go-to recently. Mouth to lung, dude. Mouth to lung. There's something there. So yeah, what I want to do now is take you to the new and improved beer segment. All right, well, welcome to the new beer segment. We're going to be doing this a little bit differently. I generally shoot my vlogs during the day, which is great, but then I end up drinking beer at like 1 in the afternoon, which is also pretty great, but I actually want to sit and enjoy the beer, so I'm switching this, just the beer tasting portion, to kind of a more night-timey atmosphere. This is when I'm winding down, this is when I'm going to eat dinner, this is when I'm going to actually pour this beer, drink this beer, and enjoy this beer rather than like forcing myself to drink beer at 1 in the afternoon on an empty stomach like I have been doing for the vlog. So here, we're here in the evening time. It's beautiful down here in Southern California. And what I have to drink today is a Southern California beer. This comes from Refugee Brewery. And I'll post a link in the description to their website as well as, you know, the Beer Advocate website. This is the Blood Orange WIT beer. And I like a good Belgian wit beer, and I saw this at the BevMo, and it was only like, I don't know, $12, I think, for a 4-pack, so not meh, you know, not horrible, but it comes in a can, and I'm not going to drink it out of the can. I'm going to pour it. Look at that cool, I love the graphics that they use. That is cool. I'm just a sucker for good, you know, graphics and marketing and stuff like that, so this is a beer that's in a can, and I'm not going to drink it out of the can because, unlike Heady Topper, it's not instructing me to drink it out of the can. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pour it into a traditional Belgian tulip glass right over the keyboard. It's a very, very, wow, it's a very, very light beer. So I drank the other one out of the can. This is a very, very light beer. It reminds me of Hoegaarden. It's like a lemony, cloudy sort of looking big head on that. Ruby Roo, how's that? Is that okay? Should I stick my finger in there to get rid of it? Isn't that what you told us to do, Ruby Roo? I'm not going to do that. So what I'm going to do is drink through the head like a man. Let's look on the Beer Advocate site and see. So it's 5% alcohol. There are no notes for this. So let's go to the Refugee Brewery. Yeah, now available on shelves. So tell me more about your beer. Summer Nights 2015. Nope. Blood Orange Wit had the humblest of beginnings. A simple offering from the tasting room locals completely changed the direction of the brewery and our brand. Ken and Tina have property up in the hills behind the brewery, and their land was filled with citrus and avocado trees from east to west. I don't know. This isn't describing the beer to me. Amongst the grove of avocados, navel oranges, and lime trees grew a tree and unlike the others. The fruit was smaller, with dark burgundy pulp. Not having much experience with blood oranges or fruit in general, we were not exactly sure how to brew with them. Nevertheless, we went for it and just added the whole fruit, peel and all, to the batch of Belgian-style wit beer. This result was amazing and almost overnight became our best-selling and most popular beer. So you can get a 4-pack of it at your local BevMo or whatever, what have you. I am a fan of Blood Orange, and I don't want to completely give away what's coming up in the future, but we do have a Grim Cult juice that's going to drop at some point that, oh my god, it's going to pair just freaking perfectly. In fact, the Rainbow Sherbet and the Dark would pair well with this. I have a feeling this top secret juice in my box mod with the Mad Hatter drip tip on there, atomizer, is going to pair even better with it. But first, let's have a sip. Here's to ya. Cheers. Cheers. Delicious, refreshing orange peel. Orange peel on top of orange peels on top of orange peels. That's what I get from this. It's like a little Hoegaarden-y, very citrusy, very Hoegaarden-y orange peels. That's all I get, is just a load of orange peels on top of this. It's good. And I have a feeling that this vape is just going to pair perfectly with it. Yes. Oh my God. That is insane. This is the best pairing I've ever done, and I can't tell you what juice this is. Oh, what a letdown. It's okay. It's okay. We move forward. You'll all find out in good time. One thing that I really like to do when I'm drinking beer is, looks like it has a bigger head on it now, doesn't it? Nope, that's just vapor. I like to inhale some vapor and take a drink and exhale through my nose, so the vapor's coming out of my nose while the beer is going into my mouth. It's just a delightful experience. Let's all try it together. Everybody over here, you got your mods. Everybody over here, you got your beer, this beer. Just a wonderful experience. Anyway, that's what I got for beer. So now I'll wind down this evening with some beer, and we'll get back to the normal daytime vloggy time. It is shout-out time. All right, so here we go with the shout-outs. We're going to try to keep this quick. We're already running long in this vlog, as we usually do. I want to give a shout-out to Joe. So a fellow named Joe, let me get to him. Joe emails me, and he emails me. I'm just going to read the email. I want to give him a shout out. I says, I know this will just sound crazy, but I'm asking anyway. I am probably not the only person to ask you something like this, so I don't feel totally foolish. I'm 34 years old, and I've been watching your videos for 4 years now. I feel like we may be brothers from another mother. So check this out. On Wednesday, September 23rd, the Mighty Ghost will be playing at the historic Newport Music Hall in Columbus, Ohio, so I bought you a ticket. So I need you to get here. Stay with me and my wife for a few days. All your meals are covered, your craft beer is covered, a place to stay is covered, and now your music is covered. We can pick you up at the airport and get you back. Let me know. You're always saying, let's hang out and have a beer, let's vape and chat. I know this, while I know this is usually referring to vape meets, this is as cool as I can make it. He gives me his phone number. He says, I put a few attachments in this email as well. He says, while I do know what your answer probably will be, I still want to hang out sometime in this lifetime. If you want to mention the crazy person who asked you to do all this in a vlog sometime, you are more than welcome to. And he sent me a screen cap. I mean, he sent me a picture of the ghost tickets. And dude, Joe, you look like a normal guy. It looks like you have a wonderful family, and your wife and your dog looks adorable. September, I've already replied to him, but it's just out of the realm of possibility, unfortunately. But you, Joe, get a shout out and go to the ghost show, rock out, drink beer, and enjoy yourself. So absolutely, Joe, thank you so much for the offer. That is a very humbling offer to get. Unfortunately, I just won't be able to fly to Columbus, Ohio, September 23rd to stay with you and your wife. So that's just, I apologize. But Joe, you're a good guy. Next, I want to give a shout out to Cody. So Cody sends me a picture. Where is this picture? He sent me a picture of a Grim Army sticker that he put on his motorcycle. Just looks so cool. Put it on like the front fender of his motorcycle. It's like a little crotch rockety motorcycle. Very, very cool. I think that's awesome. Joe, thank you. And you guys, if you get, we don't sell the Grim Army stickers individually. We usually send them out with Neighbor Juice orders. So if you guys get any Grim Army stickers, and you can pick them up at vape shows as well, and you've put them somewhere cool, like on, I don't know, your vape case or your car or your motorcycle or your wall or something like that, send me a picture. I would love to see that, and additionally I would love to shout you out. I do have a couple more shout outs that are going to happen. I'm going to try to wrap this up. This email comes to me from Michael. Says, "What's up, Nick? My name is Michael. I've recently decided to give up tobacco and take up vaping. This isn't about me, though. I give full credit to whom I know would absolutely love a shout-out in one of your vlogs. I was really hoping you could do this for me. It would really make her and his day. About 2.5 weeks ago, I went and visited my sister and her boyfriend of many years, Courtney and David. And them being smokers for years, have given it up as well. I smoked for around 3 years, and I gave them full credibility for me quitting." I think the word you're looking for is credit. But credibility could be a word. "They watch your vlogs every week and have actually taken a like to, and I have actually taken a like to them myself. I now have almost completely put down smoking, except on very, very small occasions. I know it would mean a lot to them and be a surprise and have you give them a shout out. Hopefully you can make their day as well as mine. If you are able to, please let me know. I will make sure they don't miss it. Thank you for what you do. It's very enjoyable. I love you. P.S. I love you." He wrote P.S. I love you. Absolutely. Yeah. Courtney, David, Michael, you are all shouted out. Michael, stick with it, man. Vaping gets easier the longer that you do it. And there's no, I've always said this to a lot of people, there's no rules in vaping. If vaping gets you down from a pack a day to like a pack a week at first, and then you're able to do like a cigarette a day maybe, or a cigarette on the weekends, and then you know what I mean? You can use vaping to cut down on your tobacco and eventually hopefully give it up altogether. So absolutely stick with it, Michael. And absolutely thank you, Courtney and David, for watching the vlogs. It's very, very much appreciated. And thank you for getting Michael there on the right track to vaping. I do have another shout out here. "Hi, Nick. My name is Shireen." I said it correctly, I believe, because she phonetically spelled it for me. "Shireen. And I watch your vlogs religiously. I've been vaping for 8 months, and in that time I have converted 3 of my close friends, but that's not my biggest achievement in vaping. My biggest achievement is today, June 17th, 2015, I'll be going to see my mom on her 51st birthday, and giving her first setup, an iStick 30 watt and a Pro Tank Mini. Mama C is what all my friends and family know her as, and she is my hero. She has COPD, one working lung, and has to take a huge amount of medication to stay alive. It is very often housebound. Through all of that, she never complains and holds our family together, but has still smoked about 3/4 of a pack a day. I saw her yesterday, and she was very excited. I brought her last pack, and told me she's gotten the go ahead from her specialist doctor. I'm hoping vaping will improve her quality of life. Anyway, I would love for her to get a shout out from you and to show her everyone has nothing but support for her, and the vape community is as friendly as I have told her. Thank you for all your videos. I hope you have a good day." Absolutely, Shireen and Mama C. You guys are both getting shout outs. Absolutely, Mama C. I hope the vaping works for you. And congratulations, Shireen, on being tobacco free and then getting your mom into it. That's what we do with vaping. We proselytize it. We want people that we know and love who are smokers to kind of make that switch. I hate forcing it on people. I've met people around in the California area who are smokers who end up being friends and who kind of, they're hesitant. They're kind of like, ugh, vaping. Ugh. And you go, no, okay. Well, if you want to try it, obviously that would be the best thing. If you don't want to try it, I'm not going to force it on you. But we get very excited about it because it worked for us. We want other people to be excited about it as well. Absolutely. One last shout out. Advocacy request, advocacy/shout out request. "Dear Nick, this is not a request for me. It's for a guy/company. His name is Eric, and he is a stage 4 cancer patient. He runs an online vape store. I will admit it's not the biggest vape store online, but he does donate 40% of the proceeds to cancer charities. I am not affiliated with him in any other way other than I asked to share his story and his website. He has a full bio on his website. I hope you at least mention him for his work and while he himself is not well. Thank you for your time. Absolutely, Robert and Eric, consider yourselves both shouted out, especially Eric, but he does have a website, vapewisecharity.com. I am 18. Let's go inside. And evidently, he donates 40% of his sales to cancer charities. And I think that's, that's a thing. We all have stuff that we believe in. And obviously, this has affected Eric in a huge, huge way. So he runs a vape shop and wants to give back. Look, he's got the EVIC VT kit for $89. You can go buy an EVIC VT kit from Eric and know that 40% of your money is going to charity. So I'll post a link in the description. Absolutely, absolutely, Robert and Eric, keep doing your thing. I'll post a link in the description to where you can check that out if you want to. So we covered Kaiser Permanente, we covered the CDC, we covered titanium wire, SB140, and we did some shout outs. What I want to do now is some first impressions. So the first impression that I want to do is for this mod, okay? This is called the HOhm, and it comes from thehotmodshop.com. That's an interesting, thehotmodshop.com. Put some juice on this coil. Now, I got this at in Pittsburgh. I got this at the VCCPA event, and a guy named Hank Undenell on Instagram. He handed me off this mod, and what it is, it's a 3D printed mod, and it's dual 26650. So I have two 26650s in there, and it's running series rather than parallel. So parallel is going to give you the same voltage. Series is going to give you double the voltage. It's basically like stacking batteries. You get around 7.5-ish volts. So what I had to do was none of my existing atomizers, they were all built very, very low, wouldn't run on this series box. I'm going to experiment around and see what ohms actually will work well on series, because I have two series boxes now. So what I did, just for the sake of this video, is I tried to find an atomizer that would work with his special top cap. So it comes with a matchy-matchy top cap. See how matchy-matchy that is? But my favorite atomizers don't work with this top cap. The tugboats, no go. Tugboats don't work with it. I tried a whole bunch of atomizers, and finally I grabbed the switch mod atomizer, which is just a three-post design on here. Juice. Three-post design. So I built a single coil. I did 14 wraps of 26-gauge canthal. It came out to 1.4 ohms, and it's running at 7 volts. It's great. I mean, the vapor production coming off of the single coil is ridiculous. But the problem I'm running into with this mod are two. There are two problems I'm running into with this mod. I don't like the airflow of this top cap. I just downright loathe it. If you can see on here, which you can't really, there's a bunch of airflow slots in the bottom, right? Those go up and up, in and up, and then on the inside around the top are also airflow slots. So it goes in and up and then down and then up, if that makes any sense at all. It's very, very airy, and the chamber is a little bit big in here. And the flavor is not exactly what I'm looking for. I do realize that this is a single coil, 1.4 ohms, running at over 7 volts. So the flavor already is going to be a little bit weird. But when you add that super huge airflow in there, just makes it it makes it even more weird. The performance is nice. I've noticed that the vapor is a little wispy. It's not like thick. Like if I take a drag off of this tank, the vapor is really thick. If I take a drag off of this, the vapor is not as thick. Again, I realize, yes, this is a single coil in here, but there's something about this airflow. Let me put the original top cap on here and see if that changes anything. I'm going to put the original Switch Mods top cap on here. Yeah, it's thicker. It's much, much thicker. World's thicker. World's thicker. And then I put his top cap on here. It just feels a lot wispier. And you kind of notice it was green and now it's yellow. So this is a heat reactive plastic. So this is a 3D printed mod and it's heat reactive. So if you're holding it a certain way, it will react with the heat of your fingers. Additionally, this top cap turns from like a green to a yellow. It's like the old hypercolor shirts. Remember the old hypercolor shirts where it's like turns from pink to purple when you put your hand on it? Same idea. My thumb was right there, so now it's pink. My fingers are yellow, so my fingers were right here, now it's purple. I've been putting my mouth on the top cap, so now it's turning slightly yellow. It's kind of cool. I mean, that aspect of it, I think, is kind of cool. Unnecessary, but still kind of cool. I don't know what it is. The something about this top cap makes the vapor really feels really intense and very wispy. The other top caps I see on the website are normal. They have just dots. Like, that's kind of the top cap I would like. If this just had like three big 3mm airflow holes in there or something, I think I would like it a lot more. The vapor just feels wispy. Now, apart from wispy vapor, the other problem I run into is this door. So this door is held on by magnets. And there's magnets kind of in the seam of this door. You see right here, your batteries are going to rest on either side of this seam, and then there's four magnets. 1, 2, 3, 4. Kind of 3D printed into it. Like, he was printing it, and then he put the magnets in there, and then printed the last, like, two little stripes over it, so it holds the magnets in there. And those hold on to the battery. And it's not super, super snappy on there, but the door stays on there okay. When I'm using it, the door stays on there. There's a lot of play back and forth with those magnets. The magnets, I can hear them in their little chambers, and they're not in there snug, so they keep clacking back and forth. A lot of side to side on this. A lot of side to side on this. A lot of side to side on this. Both of these doors come off. Let me pop my batteries out of here. Both of these doors come off. They're both held on by magnets. So on this side, there's magnets right there that go onto the metal right there. So it snaps on, no play. No play at all. None up and down, side to side, no play on that door. But when I put my batteries in here, and I have to remember that this is a series mod, I get a lot of play. Get a lot of play side to side. And I remember he mentioned something about this slot. He's like, oh, I have a thing in my car for that slot. And you stick it in there, and maybe that will help keep the door from having so much play on it. As it stands, I wish I had a matchy-matchy top cap that didn't have this airflow. It's okay, it's just weird, and I like it. I much prefer it with the regular airflow. And like I said, this is I have two series boxes now, so I need to try to find a build that works well with series. When I was at the last OC Vapors Club meet, Omboyak, Omboy OC was there, and he had a stacked 26650 mod, and he was running a 0.2 ohm build on it, parallel 24 gauge, I believe, 0.2 ohm build at 7 volts, and I was like, what? So I'm going to fiddle around and see what builds I can do. If anybody has any suggestions on what builds I can do to run at that high of a voltage, please let me know in the comments below. And yeah, I'll rock it out. But with the normal switch mod atomizer top cap on there, much better vape. So yeah, that's the HOhm mod, and I'll have a link in the description if you wish to check it out. They're 3D printed mods, and you can pick a bunch of different colors, lime green and black, orange, and you can make one that's really gross. You can make one that's like red and lime green, or orange and lime green. It just looks like barf. But yeah, it's cool. Obviously, like with all my first impressions, I do need to spend more time with it before I feel comfortable talking about it in full review. I do also want to give a quick shout out to Miss Amanda M up in Canada. Her fucking store got bombed. Straight up bombed. And I'm getting texted. Straight up bombed. That is ridiculous. Evidently, up in Canada, up in that area, there is some major intense beef between shops, and I don't want to say anything, but their store got bombed. It's ridiculous. But she did send me her whole line of new liquids. This is Teas by Ember Liquids. Quite delicious. I have yet to try the other ones, but so far this one has been top notch. But it's not about that. I just wanted to give a quick shout out to Amanda. This definitely needs a new battery. So moving on to my other first impression that I want to do. So this is a weird box, man. So this box came from Gear Spec, and I'll post a link in the description, gearspec.com. They have a, no, I don't want a coupon code. Welcome to Gear Spec. Yes. Gear Spec. They make a device, and I can't tell, it's called the American Muscle. Okay, it says the latest evolution of the classic box mod with modern features. Dual 18650 box can handle builds down to 0.08 ohms below that, and safety features will kick in and not let the box fire to prevent damaging the box or batteries. It has a built-in micro USB charging port up here. The back has a four-stage LED light. Simple press of the button, and you can see the life of your batteries. Right now I'm down to three dots, which I don't know exactly what that means, but I'm down to three dots. So it can handle up to 50 amps, 4.2 maximum voltage on freshly charged batteries, auto power off when resistance dips below 0.08 ohms, over voltage 4.3 volt protection, over current 2 amp protection, overheat protection, 4-stage battery indicator, input charging is 1 amp, ultra fast charging. So basically this is a parallel box mod. You have to unscrew the face of it to get your batteries in, but you charge it via the USB, which is kind of, I don't know how I feel about that yet. I am so used to parallel box mods, like the My Box, your mom's box, the Tugboat, that I can just pop this off, replace the batteries, and put them back in. I used to love the idea of charging just a box and not having to deal with batteries, but now, as I've grown and changed as a vapor, I actually like popping out the batteries and batteries and just putting them back in. The only wonky thing about this, the size is a little weird. It's long. It's tall. It's taller than that Tugboat box. Same exact diameter otherwise. It's just a little taller. I guess that's to fit more of the electronics in there. Additionally, it uses this button that I'm not super stoked on. It's a squishy button. And it does not have a spring-loaded 510. So you see this gap in here from rocking my Twisted Messes? I thought this looked cool. I was like, blue. Blue Twisted Messes RDA, blue mod, and a blue dot mod drip tip. It looks cool. The performance is top-notch. If this had a spring-loaded 510, I think I would be much more excited about it. Performance has been fucking phenomenal, and it's a cool aluminum lightweight box. It says it's called the American Muscle, and it says designed in California, but I get the feeling that this was made in China, and I have no way to prove that. No way to prove it, but I have a feeling these are fabricated and manufactured in China, and designed in California, because I feel like if it was made in California, they would have put made or manufactured in California rather than just designed in California. It's not necessarily like the end of the world. I'm just saying it's a thing. The great thing about this mod, $58. If it had a spring-loaded 510 connection, I would be recommending this to literally everybody I know. It does not have a spring-loaded 510 connection right now. $58, you don't really need your vape budget hands, but if you have atomizers like the Twisted Messes, like a lot of atomizers, like the Tugboats, they're going to not fit on here. They're just not straight up, not going to fit flush on there at all. But overall, for $58, this is pretty awesome. And again, as always, with all my first impressions, I do need to spend more time with it before it gets a full video, but so far, this has been pretty good. Alright, so let's get on to this last first impression before we do some retro vaping. TugBoat released the TugBoat version 2 mech mod, and it's very, very different. It still has a 510 connection on top, obviously, like all mods should. It's still a hybrid in there, but it got rid of the magnet system. They made it thicker. It's 24 millimeters. The copper on it is thicker. These are Cerakoted with a whole mess of colors. And I'll post a link in the description to Flawless Vape Shop. If I can find it. Yes, Flawless Vape Shop. $150 for the V2 copper Cerakoted TugBoat mod. There's black and red splatter, green with red splatter, black with Tiffany blue splatter, which is the one that Matt got, that I think looks super cool. The white and pink one I think also looks really, really cool. And it comes with a matching cap. So this is 24 millimeters. So if you were to put a normal 22 millimeter atomizer on here, the mod would be wider than the atomizer. But it comes with a top cap that matches, that already goes, that fits perfectly. Strong O-rings. It matches your mod and it fits over your regular TugBoat RDA. So I have a TugBoat version 2 on here. I put this cap on there and it magically transforms your TugBoat into a 24 millimeter RDA. So it'll match perfectly. The way they do the battery rattle situation is with this Delrin piece on the bottom that you screw up or screw down to take up for battery rattle. And it's been surprisingly good. Now, when I first got this, I'm gonna switch out the battery because that battery is dead. When I first got this, it comes with a 6-pound spring on the inside. And I, being the weakling that I am, could barely press it. I'm like digging in, trying to get this spring to go. And he's like, oh no, it's okay. We pack in a 4-pound spring as well. And I'm like, thank fucking God. So first order of business, apart from building my atomizer, was to put that 4-pound spring in there. Yeah, easy. Battery rattle, there's a little bit. Maybe I could adjust this a little bit more. But the first order of business was to get that 6-pound spring out of there, put the 4-pound spring in. Oh, perfect. And now it's still stiff. It's still stiff. It's a stiff button, but it is nice and glidey. It's got a very short throw, and it's ridiculous. This is I don't even know what this is. 0.15 or a 0.12. I think this is a 0.12 ohm build on here. Let me juice it up real fast. It's been great, and I'm so skeptical because I love the TugBoat so much. And one of the reasons I like the TugBoat is I like the deck to build on, and I like the airflow. And then the Anarchist cap came out, and I was like, wow, I really like this airflow. And then the Slam cap came out, and I was like, ooh, I don't know. And then I'm like, oh yeah, I really like this airflow. This cap came out, and I saw the big slots, and I'm like, I wonder if I'm going to like that airflow. Turns out, yes, I actually do like this airflow. And it comes with its own, you know, chuff-style, big, wide-mouth bore drip tip on there as well. And it's nice. The airflow is nice. And this is the same TugBoat that I've been using forever. And now it has a new home in a new, bigger mech mod with a new, bigger 24-millimeter cap on top. It's a nice warm vape. It's very, very flavorful, of course, because it's the TugBoat, which I really, really like. It's been so good. It's been so far so good. So far so good. That's what I'm going to say. So far so good. I feel that the 6-pound spring in there is completely unnecessary. I mean, who are you trying to impress? 4-pound spring, nice and stiff, a little bit stiff, but it's got such a short throw that you can kind of press it every time. Hits amazing. I mean, it hits really well because it's 100% copper with copper contacts. Works great. $150. They upped the price by $50. The original tugboats are $100. These are $150. I have a feeling these will go down in price as time goes on, like a lot of things do. But for that $150, you're getting the mod and a new matching top cap that already works with the tugboats that you may or may not already have. So yeah, good times. Good times here with the tugboat. So moving forward, we've already done a whole mess of stuff. What I want to do right now after that is some retro vaping. So many, many years ago, I got on YouTube and I raved about this device. And in retrospect, it's not quite amazing, but it's still pretty fucking cool. The big problem I have with this device now is the price. They're still selling this device for $84.99. What we're talking about is the Vapor for Life Vapor Zeus. I loved this thing. It was a huge cartomizer, huge battery, and an auto switch. So you could just sit, and the cartomizer has this rubber squishy tip, so you can just bite it. You just bite it. I loved it. This cartomizer is at least 2 years old now. I don't even know what juice is in here anymore. It doesn't look good. So I went digging and I found a brand freaking new. In fact, I'm going to throw this one away. Just, I mean, the difference in, this is the one that's old, this is the brand new one. Look at that, look how difference that is. One's just super dirty. You're going right into the trash can, buddy boy. So what I did is I went back and I found an old Vapor for Life. I actually have two more of these. Vapor for Life, Vapor Zeus cartomizers. Now these are big ass cartomizers. There's a lot of polyfill in there. And then I went and grabbed some old school classic Namber juice, a 15 mil bottle of Atlanta Peach Leaf. These are all 50-50 juices, which in cartomizers work, they work great. It works amazing in cartomizers. So I'm just going to top this off. I've slowly been filling it over the day. It takes a while to fill these cartomizers. You kind of have to fill them up and then get the juice going where it needs to go, and that's looking good. So I'm going to put this on here, and hopefully it will give me a good vaping experience. Let's see if it works. The flavor is just top notch. God, I miss that Atlanta Peach Leaf. We need to do that in Max VG. That's all there is to it. Still works like the day I got it. I charged this overnight. I got a brand new cartomizer on here. I'll post the link in the description to where you can watch my original video. But man, I went crazy for this thing. And now going on the Vapor for Life website, the Vapor Zeus Auto Premium Kit is $84.99. One Vapor Zeus Auto e-cig battery, two Smilomizers, one USB charging cable, one slim wall adapter, one 30 ml bottle of liquid, and one classic Smilomizer tip. I think these are great. It outputs 5 volts. It's only got so this is the extra large version with the 1300 milliamp hour battery, which is an extra $8. So now you're up to $92.99. The small has a 650 mAh, the medium has a 900 mAh, and the XL has a 1300 mAh. The thing is, it's a good long battery life, and I remember saying this before, but you're using it at a consistent 5 volts, You're not using a lot of wattage. You're not using a lot of amperage. So your battery life, 1300 mAh, lasts a good long time. I have a very vivid memory of taking this exact... Talk much? I have a very vivid memory of taking this exact setup to Las Vegas with me, and I kept a little bottle of juice in my pocket, and I just rocked this. One battery, one cartomizer all night long, and I would occasionally open this up and top it off, but it was great. If and when someday I go back to Vegas, yes, I'm going to take this, and I'm going to sit in a lounge with a martini, and I'm going to vape this. That's what I'm going to do. I think it's still awesome. I think it's still rad. I'm going to keep this around. I'm going to put it right there in my Millennium Falcon, and I'm going to rock it. I'm going to put this in here. I'm going to put this somewhere. But yeah, Vapor for Life, the Vapor Zeus, I still think this is a fan-freaking-tastic product. The problem is it's hard to get someone into vaping with this, because if they get this and they use it and they like the way it vapes, they're kind of limited to just this. This isn't compatible with anything else. It's got a 901, old 901 connection on there. You're not going to be able to use an RDA on this. You're not going to be able to adjust the watts on this. You're not going to be able to really use this cartomizer on anything else either. So if someone gets into vaping because of this, then they're kind of going to be limited to just this. If you're already a vapor and you want something that looks boss, like a big cigar, has an auto switch on it, and has a big ass cartomizer that holds a whole mess of juice, dude, Vapor for Life. They're still selling them. They're still selling these. But yeah, I'm just going to enjoy some vapor right now. So yeah, that's some retro vaping with the Vapor for Life Vapor Zeus. I'll link again to my original video and to vaporforlife.com, where you can check it out if you're so interested. So this vlog, we're wrapping this vlog up. We're wrapping it up. I'm not going to do any music. Let me relook at my notes just to make sure. Not going to do any music. I'm not going to do any viewer mails because we're already running quite long. I'm not going to be able to do any music, but I do want to say, let me pull up this website. I'm going, let's see. Nope. This weekend, this Friday night. So the day that you're watching this is Thursday. Tomorrow night, I am going to see Slayer and King Diamond. I could not be more excited. I am so unbelievably excited. I've never got to see Slayer live. I've never got to see King Diamond live. And I'm going to see both Slayer and King Diamond live. And a bunch of other bands that I could really give two shits about. It's like an all-day thing. This is the Rockstar Mayhem Festival. Slayer, King Diamond, Hell Yeah. I'd like to go see Hell Yeah. The Devil Wears Prada, no interest in them. Thy Art Is Murder, don't care. Whitechapel, nope. Jungle Rot, oh, I used to listen to Jungle Rot. Sister Sin, Sworn In, Shattered Sun, Feeder to the Sharks, Code Orange, and Kissing Candace. I'm going to go see this. I can't wait. I think it's going to be super cool, and I'm pretty excited about it. Slayer and King Diamond. That's who I'm going to see this weekend. That's going to be amazing. I'm going to wrap this vlog up. Thank you so much, everybody, for joining me one more time on the vlog. There's a lot of cool stuff coming up. I'm going to be at VaporCon West next in July 10th and 11th, Reno, Nevada, VaporCon West. It's going to be just a big party. After that, of course, is ECC. After that is Vape Mania in September in Winston-Salem, North Carolina. I'll be going back there. So, should be good times. Got a lot of stuff coming out. Still hanging in there with the MechMon Monday, Topper Tuesday, Wildcard Wednesday. I found that that's working really well. The people who like MechMods, they watch on Monday because they like MechMods. And the people who aren't interested in MechMods, they don't have to watch on Monday. And it works out really well. In fact, Friday... Tomorrow, I am going to be uploading another video, And really, this video, all truly and honestly, is to help my brother build his atomizers. It's a quick 20-minute long video. It's everything from beginning to end of my most simple, effective way to build an atomizer. It's the build that I have on this tugboat right here. And so you can see the performance is top-notch. It's just a good, quick little build. I put it on video. It's mostly for my brother. But with that said, I hope that a lot of people can benefit from it. But yeah, I'm going to wrap this up. We're done. Hope you enjoyed the new beer segment. Hope you enjoyed the whole vlog. As always, everybody, what am I going to grab? What am I going to grab? Okay, how about this? How about this thing? Let's keep on vaping.
Alright, thanks everyone for watching, and if you like this vlog, feel free to go back and check out my weekly review series. I'll have them linked below: Mech Mod Monday, Topper Tuesday, and Wildcard Wednesday. And lastly, comments, feedback, likes, and subscriptions are always appreciated. Thanks so much, everyone.